Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture on the SPSS. Today we will discuss how we can implement this one-way ANOVA in the SPSS software. Myself, Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, India. Contact me, either of my email IDs are there if you feel any doubt, else simply follow this link for finding the more updated videos on the SPSS and probability stat. What we will look in this lecture is, we will see how we can perform the one-way ANOVA for the independent groups in the SPSS. Also, we can see how we can interpret the results using this Turkey hypothesis of the testing are there. So first of all, this one-way ANOVA is also called as the one-factor ANOVA. Also, it is called as the one-way analysis of the variance, and it is called as the between the subjects ANOVA. So all are called as this one-way ANOVA. Secondly, once we are working on this ANOVA, there is a need of the two variables. One is called as the dependent variable and second is the independent variable. Independent variable is also called as the grouping variable or called as the factor. So if you look about the on your SPSS window, you can see there is a variable called as the dependent, you can see, and here is called as the factor. That factor is also called as the independent variable. So it means you have to define firstly the two groups here. We will see in detail one by one steps how we can perform that. Where you can use this ANOVA is, commonly used in the field study experiments. So whenever you have to analyze your information or data from the field study or from the experimental works or from the quasi-experimentals are there. So whenever you have the information or the data collection from such studies, then you can simplify this ANOVA for your beneficiary results. In order to apply this study, you have to satisfy certain requirements. The first one is that whatever the dependent variable you have, it must be a continuous. So how you can define the continuous? It must be like, say, the weight of the students, height of the students, marks obtained by the students, all are my continuous variable. Second thing, whatever the independent variable is, that it must be of the nominal or the ordinal form. That is, it may be categorized like some male or female, employed or unemployed, machines are there, and so on. After that, whatever the observation you have taken, they are independent to each other, and the samples you have taken from the populations are randomly distributed. And the major restriction is that you have to check the homogeneity of the variance, and the population must have the normal distribution. Finally, there is no outlier between their samples. What is the hypothesis of this one sample, one way ANOVA? All the, if you have the K population means, then your H0 is that all the population means are equal, while your H1 is at least one of them is equal. So at least one of them equal means it can be possible like mu1 is not equal to mu2, but maybe is equal to all others are there. It may be possible that mu1 is same as that of mu2, but is not equal to the mu of 3, and while all are same, and so on. So how many possibilities are there? So we can say at least one of them is not same. And how we can check that? This we can check based on the post hoc test that we will see in this SPSS. How you can perform that? And what is that test statistic? Is that we will try to complete this ANOVA table. That is, this is called as the degree of freedom. This is called as the sum of the square. MSS is called as the mean sum of the square. And this is the F ratio. So if you have the k number of the samples are there, then the degree of freedom will be my k minus 1. Total is my n, then degree of freedom is n minus 1, and so on. F ratio is calculated by this divided by this. SS is the sum of square. TR is called as the treatment. E is called as the error. Capital T is called as the total. How you find the MSS is, this is the SS divided by degree of freedom. That is, this value is computed by SS of treatment divided by the their degree of freedom. Similarly, you can find this value as SS error divided by their degree of freedom. Now, how you can define your information into the SPSS? That is the most important thing. So as we discussed that there are the two variables. One is the independent and second is the dependent variable. Whatever you have the independent variable, we must categorize. We must be use the categorical information like say nominal or ordinal. On the other hand, whatever you have the dependent variable, that must be the continuous. So you can use them on the purpose of the scale. Once you are using this, then you have to define each of the informations here. For example, If I consider this example for you, if you read this example, there are the three different ovens are there and which are used to heat the metal specimens. So in order to use them, there are obvious that the temperature of this of the ovens are vary and they are recorded like this. So in this case, you can see these are the different ovens are there. These are my different samples. Now, since it has more than of the two samples, so you can apply this one way ANOVA. Also, you can see the number of the elements in the first oven is my 5. Number of the elements in the second oven is my 4. This is my 6. Since all are not equal, you can say N1 is not equal to it here. So it means this is a one way ANOVA. So now your target is to input this information into the SPSS. So we have to think firstly, there are the two independent and the dependent variable. So first one is the dependent variable, that is this 494 is dependent on the oven A. So all these variables, whatever you have defined here, this is my dependent, and this A, B, C is my independent. That is oven are my independent, temperature is my dependent. So you can go to your SPSS, go to your variable view, define the two name, one is the temperature, second is the oven. Make sure that it must be of the numeric. After writing this, then what you can do is you have to write this 494, 497 all in the temperature are here. So once, then you can click on this data view. You can see there are the two options for you. That is a temperature and oven. You can put the informations for that. This value is for the oven one. One is for the, I can define one for the oven A, two for the oven B, C, three for the oven C. So these are the first five values corresponding to the, these are the temperature values for the oven A, similarly for the oven B and C. So once you are defining this information into your SPSS, now what you can do is, you can simply go to the analyze, you can see that, compare mean and one way ANOVA to perform that. So once you will click on this analyze, compare mean, one way ANOVA, you will get this output window. You can see this is my nominal or ordinals are there. So one is the dependent, which one is the dependent is, this temperature is my dependent. So you can click temperature on here, and this is my independent group. So which one is the independent here is, oven is my independent. So you can put oven into the here. So you can write here. Once you are defining this, you can see that still OK button is not activate. But once you will click on this all here, now OK button is activate. So before pressing this OK button, you can click on this post hoc. Once you will click on this post hoc, this window will appear. What is the meaning of these post hocs are there? So you can see in this example, what is your H0 for this example? So you can see mu of A is mu of B is mu of C. And what is the H1 is? At least one of them differ. So at least one of them differ. So which one is the differ? Either A is not equal to B, or A is not equal to C, or B is not equal to C, or C is not equal to A, and so on. So in order to analyze which one will satisfy this at least one of them, we have to perform this post hoc multiple comparison test like here. Post hoc button will tell you which of the various pairs of the mean difference is significant. So how you can do that? Once you will click on this, then you can see there are the two options. One is the equal variance assumed. Second is the equal variance not assumed. Since our assumption is that equal variance assumed, so you can click on this turkey. You can set the level of significance as a 0.05 or whatever you want as your level of significance alpha. So since by default is a 5%, also you can see is a by default is my two-sided target. So once you will put this turkey and the level of significance, you can click on this continue button, you are here. Now you can click on this option button. Once you will click on this, now these are all based on your descriptive statistics. This is the requirement because that's one of the assumption that the variance should be the same. So you must click on this. And if you want to put up as a descriptive statistics like here, what is the meaning of the descriptive is? That is you want to calculate the mean, standard deviation, variance, etc. Then you want to click here. If you want to plot the mean of this first oven, mean of the second oven, then you can click on this mean plot. Once you will click on that, you can finally click on this continue and finally click OK. So once you will click on this OK, you can see this is the output window are here. So this you can see on the first window, that is the descriptive. Why this table appears? because you click on here. If you uncheck on this, then this table will not appear. So as the name suggests, this is the value of the ovens. These are my oven. You can see the how many temperatures in the oven. One is 5. The mean is my 491. Standard deviation is this. Confidence bounds are there, minimum value and the maximum are there. Similarly, you can find this is the second oven, consists of the mean are here and so on. And these are the total 15 elements are there, mean and there. Now this is the important thing. This is the most important thing. Now since this is the homogeneity of variance, so what is that? Your H0 in case of homogeneity of variance is there, whether this is true or not. How you can check that? You can always look about the SIG value. It is also called as the P value. P value is called as nothing but my probability value. So if you look about this, this is my SIG value. And this H0 is accepted. You can accepted H0 when this is accepted when your SIG value is greater than of your level of significance. This is my level of significance. So in this particular example, what is your level of significance? This is 0.05, and you can see this 0.845 is greater than my 0.05. It means this is my accepted. What is the meaning of that? Is homogeneity of variance is my accepted. Once it is accepted, then you can only perform this ANOVA table. So now this is the second table. Now if you scroll down below, you can see this at the third table. Now once the homogeneity of variance will appears, again you can see, once you will do it manually, you can see this is the degree of freedom, this is my SS, this is my mean sum of the squares, and finally this is my F ratio. How you compare them in terms of the SPSS? Again you can see this SIG value. You can see again, you can accept only when this value is greater than your level of significance. Since in this example, we set the level of significance as a 0.05. So you can see this value is my 0.84. Or you can simply draw this graph. This is my 1 level of significance. This is my 100. Level of significance is my 0.05. So where this value lies, that 0.084 lies here. This is my accepted H0. This is my rejected H0. So since value lies here, or you can simply take off like this. So we can accept it H0. So what is the meaning of the H0 in this case? Is there is no difference between their ovens are there. You can see, you can conclude that there is no statistical difference generated by the mean difference between the pairs of the oven. Also, you can look about this post hoc tables are there. If you compare the 1 and 2 by using the t-test, because there are the two sample, you can see the SIG value. So you can see again 0.464 is greater than your alpha, that is a 0.05. So what is the meaning of that? There is no significant difference between your oven 1 and 2. Similarly, you can see whether there is any significant difference between the 1 and 3. 0.069 is greater than of 0.05. It means there is no significant difference between 1 and 3. Similarly, you can compare with that 2 and 1. So you can see what is that 2 and 1 is 0.464, which is again greater than of the alpha. 0.557 is again greater than of the alpha. And you can see all those values which are here is greater than of alpha. So therefore, based on this multiple comparison test, that is based on this turkey are there, you can see there is no statistical difference between their ovens. So this is the interpretation of this example. Quickly move on, the second examples are there. Again, what is that? You have the different lifetimes are there. And since this 50.1 is depends only on this type 1, that is, this is my battery type 1. So that's why this is called as the one-way ANOVA. So once it is a one-way ANOVA, how you can perform that again? Now there are the two. This is the lifeline and this is the battery type. So you can define the two columns. One is the life, second is the battery. You can see I put all these 5 values, 50.1, 49.4 and up to the 50 for this here. And these are the battery ones, so I can define as a battery one. Similarly, you can define here 50.60. You can see 50.60 and 51, 50 and so on. This is for the battery 2, so I can define as a battery 2 and so on. And then again, how you can perform them? You can simply go to analyze. You can simply go to analyze, then compare mean, and then one way ANOVA. Once you will click on this, you can put life is my dependent, battery is my factor. Again, click on the postdoc. You can select the turkey and the level of significance. And again, you can click on this option. You can put up the descriptive, homogeneity, mean plots, and so on. Finally, you can press the OK. You will get this required output. This is the descriptive statistics. Again, homogeneity of the variance. What is the SIG value? Is my 0.051, which is greater than of the 0.05. That is my alpha. So what is the meaning of that? That is, homogeneity of variance is my accepted. So that means we can say there is no significant difference between their variances of the battery life. And again, you can see now you can see the SIG, which is less than of the value of the alpha. So it means we will reject it H0. So once it is rejected, what is the meaning of that? H1 is accepted. That is, at least one of them will differ. So which one is the different? You can look about from here. So you can see the first value. What is that? This is the first battery and the second battery. So since SIG of this is again less than of the alpha, so what is the meaning of that? That is, the battery 1 and 2 is significantly different. Look at the 1 and 3. If you look at the pair of the 1 and 3, so since this number 0.745 is greater than of my 0.05, it means 1 and 3 are not here. Similarly, 2 and 1, similarly you can see the pair of the 2 and 3. Again, this value is my less than of this. So you can say the pair 2 and 3 is significantly different. Or you can say the A is not equal to B from here. That is, the 1 is not equal to 2. And 2 and 3 are also be not same. So that is, the 2 is not equal to the 3 are there. And what about the 1 and 3? You can see 1 and 3 are, 1 is greater than 0.5. So means mu of A is same as that of the C. So what is the conclusion? That you can see the battery 1 and 2 as well as the battery 1 and 3 have their significant values from here. Can you say 1 and 3? No. 1 and 2 and 2 and 3 are there. So you can see the battery 1 and 2 and 2 and 3 are there. That is, mu of, you can say battery 1 is not equal to battery 2, battery 2 is not equal to battery 3, while battery 1 is same as that of here. So that is the comparison and the significance of this one-way ANOVA. So I can summarize all these steps here. You can simply drop this and this also on. So we will see in the next class how we can perform this two-way ANOVA in the SPSS. Till then, simply follow this link for finding the more videos. Best of luck, students. Happy learning.